to speak with you all this afternoon. As Kathy indicated, I'm going to talk to you about a research project that my institute recently completed. Very active and essential support from Dr. Kathy, her organization, and other Muslim and non-Muslim organizations across the country. I'll apologize right now for the cough. I'm at the back end of a cold, and the cough is what's left. I want to start with some background about the research, just to give you the proper context. As Kathy indicated, back in 2006, we did a survey of Muslims in Canada. The impetus for this was research done by the US-based Pew Research Center, with doing research with Muslims and non-Muslims in a number of countries. They didn't include Canada in their research. Initially, we were very disappointed that Canada was not included in its important research. And then we got inspired to fill this gap. So we conducted our own Canadian version of the same research to fill the gap and also to look at the distinctive Canadian experience of Muslims in this country. And we partnered with the CBC so that we would have media opportunity for media exposure once we were done. Why we did such a survey, I think, is will be pretty obvious to most of you. Muslims are one of the fastest growing parts of the population of Canada. There are lots of issues and controversy about Muslims in this country, certainly many challenges your community faces, this is despite the fact that we live in a multicultural and supposedly diverse society. And there really has not been any systematic opinion research with Muslims in this country, so that's something that we wanted to address. Just to show you the population statistics, if you're interested, this slide shows the growth in the Muslim population in Canada going back quite a few decades. In 2011, there were well over a million Muslims living in this country. By the end of the 2016 census, which is now underway, we expect the number will probably be somewhere over 1.5 million. Out of a population of 36 to 37. So very significant and growing. We often get asked the question, why survey? What can a survey actually do to be constructive and help address some of the issues facing your community? Well, we're researchers, so of course we think research is valuable, but beyond that, we think that survey research actually could be a fairly powerful vehicle or tool to amplify the voices of individuals in any part of society, particularly those that may be marginalized or not well understood. And in a way, help maybe address some of the stereotypes which unfortunately are out there. And when properly conducted, surveys provide credible evidence about social realities that will get accepted and be much more valid, so to speak, than anecdotes, which is often what drives people's opinions and prejudices. When you do a survey of a population of Muslims or other groups, you can understand how there are similarities or differences across the different parts of the population and not rush to the assumption that what may be true of many Muslims may or may not be true of all Muslims. So that's an important value. And finally, it's a fact that surveys attract attention, media profile and coverage. And so it's a way in which to get messages and a positive narrative out into the world, into public discussion, in a way that other ways cannot, other things will not do. And our survey did have an impact. In February 2007, CBC ran major stories on our 2006 survey, TV, radio, the internet. It happened to coincide with the launch of Little Mosque on the Prairie, completely coincidental. But the messages of the TV show and the messages of the survey were largely the same, and they reinforced one another. And we were pleased that the survey was well received by the Muslim community. Most people we talked to felt that it was constructive, and the work has been cited and used by academics, governments, and others, understanding that the Muslim community is not simply the stereotype that is sometimes presented. So that brings us to our current survey. This time, we partnered with a number of other organizations to do the research, Muslim and non-Muslim, including the Tesla Institute, the Olive Tree Foundation, the In Spirit Foundation, Canadian Race Relations Foundation, and Think for Actions, which is a Calgary-based group. So we worked on this survey collectively. This is a joint project with six organizations. And we did the partnership for three reasons. It strengthens the research, so we have the perspectives of these different organizations to help strengthen the questions and the focus, helped us secure the funds necessary to do the research, and it also helps ensure that once we're done with the study, that the results will be published and used by others, not just ourselves. The themes that we covered in this study are on the slide. You can see that there are a number of themes that were in the survey. I don't have time today to cover all of these themes. I will cover some of them. And there is a full report, as Kathy indicated, that's available at no cost on our website, and I would encourage you to have a look. And for those of you who might be interested in the research and how it was done, there were actually two surveys as part of this project. There was a survey of Muslims across Canada, a sample of 600, conducted at the end of 2015, beginning of 2016, two interviews in English, French, Urdu, and Arabic. Results accurate to plus or minus 4 percentage points. There was some additional research with Muslim youth that I'm not going to talk about today that also adds to the picture. But as we did in 2006, we also did a complementary survey of the non-Muslim population because we wanted to understand the perspectives of the rest of Canadian society towards Islam and Muslims. So we conducted that as well. In both cases, the methodology was the same methodology we used in 2006, so we can make direct comparisons. So what did we find? Let me start with the theme of personal connection to Canada. And why is this a relevant theme? Why did we pick this for our survey? Well, roughly 70% of the Muslims in Canada are immigrants, so they have been born in another country. And a majority of immigrants have come to this country in the last 10 years. So in many respects, the story of Muslims in Canada is a story of immigrants and newcomers. So connection to country is something that would be of interest. One of the findings that got the greatest media coverage when the survey was released about 3 weeks ago was the extent to which Muslims are proud to be Canadian. And so you may have heard about this. If you look at the results on the slide, you can see that a very large majority, 83% of Muslims that we surveyed said they're very proud to be Canadian, and that has increased about 10 points from 10 years ago. So that's a very strong finding in terms of the proportion who say they're very proud. If you look at the results across region, you can see that the increase has been across the country, but interesting, most dramatic in Quebec, where pride among Muslims in Quebec has really skyrocketed. What about non-Muslims on this question? Well, the results are similar, but not quite the same. About 3/4 of non-Muslim Canadians are very proud to be Canadian, but they're now trailing Muslims by about 10 points. So this is an interesting difference, and one that probably most non-Muslims would not imagine. Why are Muslims proud to be Canadian? This is an open-ended question where we didn't give people answers, they had to tell us. You can see the reasons, if you can read the slide, that this is a free country, democracy, multiculturalism, it's a peaceful, stable country, humanitarian, friendly people. These are the kinds of reasons that people give. What's notable here is that these are the same reasons that other kinds of Canadians give as well. So there's really no difference in the views of what makes this a country to be proud of. What do Muslims like least about being in Canada? Maybe not surprisingly, it's climate or the weather. We found this result in 2006, and Muslims are even more likely today to say that's the thing they like the least. And I guess the weather has become a little less predictable than it was before. But I also want to point to the bottom of the slide, and there are about 1/4 of Muslims who basically can't think of anything that they particularly dislike about being in this country. So that's quite striking as well. And similar to pride in country, is the sense of belonging that people have to being part of this country. A clear majority of Muslims say they have a very strong sense of belonging to this country. Very few say it's weak. And when we ask them, has your sense of belonging changed over the past 5 years? Most say that their sense of belonging has actually strengthened in the past 5 years, and very few say that it has weakened. So that that shows, I think, a very positive and striking result. And more, and beyond that, satisfaction with the overall direction of the country, generally speaking. Muslims are very upbeat. Almost 9 in 10 say that overall they're satisfied with the direction of the country today, a bit more than they were 10 years ago. Let's compare that with non-Muslims. So a majority say that they're satisfied with the direction of the country, but it's only 56%. It's just barely over half. So for the most part, the Muslims are actually stand out as being among the most positive of Canadians in that respect. Some of this, no doubt, has to do with the outcome of the federal election in 2015. Our survey went into the field about a month after that, so clearly that may have made a difference. Participation in the recent federal election, almost 8 in 10 Muslims in our survey said that they voted in the election. I'm sure that's much higher than it was in the previous election, and that's a really striking figure. And not surprisingly, most people who voted for the federal Liberals. And it's probably not difficult to figure out why that might not be the case. So clearly that was a factor, something which Muslims participated civically in what's happening. And here's a slide that I found a bit striking myself. 90% of the Muslims we surveyed were optimistic that the new federal government, led by Justin Trudeau, would result in a more positive relations between Muslims and non-Muslims. So clearly most of these people voted for the Liberals, but it's striking to me because I think that there may have been much more skepticism or maybe more people saying, let's wait and see. But clearly this suggests that there's a lot of hope and expectation about how things will go from here on out. And it will be interesting to revisit this question in a few years' time. Let's turn to our second theme, Muslim identity and practice. We asked about different identities that people have. How important is it to be Muslim? How important is it to people's identity to be Canadian? Is that part of their identity? And to what extent is being a member of their ethnic or cultural group part of their identity? And what we can see from the research is that more than 8 in 10 told us that being Muslim is very important to them, and being Canadian is very important to them. So I think it helps reinforce the notion that people today have multiple identities, and they're not just one thing or another. We pushed the envelope on this a little bit farther and asked people who said both being Muslim and Canadian were very important, if one of them was more important than the other. And among Muslims, about 50% of this group said being Muslim is more important. The other 50% said, well, being Canadian or both were equally important. So it's sort of split 50-50. If we compare this with non-Muslims who have a religious affiliation, we see results that are different but not that different. A little more likely to say that being Canadian is very important, but a quarter again say that both are equally important. So it does underscore the notion of multiple identities and that Muslims are as likely to say that they're Canadian as Muslim. Given that many Muslim immigrants have come to this country, which is largely a secularized environment in a broad sense, we wanted to know and get a sense of whether people's attachment to their religion changed over time. And so we asked those who came from another country whether their attachment had changed. And for the most part, the largest group said it hadn't changed, but a significant minority, 41%, said the fact that their attachment to Islam actually strengthened since they got here. And when you look at it by length of time in the country, you can see that there isn't really a whole lot of change. What it does suggest that coming from maybe a primarily Muslim country to Canada has not really weakened people's sense of attachment. And in fact, we may be seeing the reverse. There's evidence in our survey to suggest that the extent of religious observance is actually strengthening a bit, or has over the past 10 years. In this slide, we're showing the frequency of attending a mosque or community center for prayer. And you can see over to the left, the number of people who say they attend at least once a week is up higher than it was 10 years ago. And actually, this trend is strongest among younger Muslims, which is interesting. And among women, wearing head covering, that in public, that has also increased noticeably over the past 10 years. Over half of the Muslim women that we spoke with said that they do wear a head covering of some sort in public, primarily the hijab in most cases, and that's where the increase has happened, but other types of head coverings as well. And again, this increase is most noticeable among younger Muslim women, as well as those with a college or university education. So we wanted to find out whether people's Muslims felt that the religious attention of youth is growing weaker over time. Often a concern of parents is what's happening to their children and grandchildren. And so we asked this question and found that more likely than not, Muslims felt that the attachments of people were less religious than their parents by about a 2-to-1 margin, but a lot said they weren't sure or weren't really dependent. Youth were a little bit more likely to hold this view, but not dramatically. What about sources of guidance as a Muslim? This is a question we asked in an open-ended format, so we could give people a chance to tell us in their own words. As you can see, that people were most likely to talk about their mosque or their local Muslim organization. As people mentioned family, their local imam or sheikh, and then a number of other sources. But it is interesting that 4 in 10 of the Muslims we surveyed said none. They didn't or wouldn't point to a specific source of guidance as a Muslim. There's lots of interpretation we can put on these results, and I invite you to do so since I won't have much time today. The third topic is integration in Canadian society. Again, this is relevant because most Muslims are immigrants, and the fact that Islam is a religion that is a minority religion in this country, and very different from the sort of Christian majority and the Christian foundations of this country. One of the most widely quoted results from our 2006 survey was the results of this question, which was asking Muslims whether they felt most people in their community wanted to adopt local Canadian customs and ways of life, or did they want to remain distinct in their own communities and not blend so much. And what we see in 2006 and in 2016, as most Muslims are saying, most Muslims want to be part of broader Canadian society, do not want to remain distinct. This was actually a bit of a revelation to non-Muslims when they saw these results, because that is not the general perception. When we put the same question to non-Muslims, the answer was quite different. Non-Muslims tend to assume that Muslims want to remain distinct, remain in their own enclaves, not become part of broader Canadian society. Not because they know this or particularly informed, but this is just the perception that they have from the media or whatever. Thank you. So there is this perception in the broader world that Muslims do not want to be part of Canadian society. But I think the good news is, if you look at the results from 2006 and 2016, that they're less likely to think this than they were 10 years ago. So perhaps they read our survey results in 2006. A different and perhaps more important way to look at the same issue is to ask Muslims and non-Muslims, what are the important values that immigrants should adopt when they come to this country? And here are the results. And again, this is an open-ended question. I'm going to have lots of water by the end of this. Thank you. That's four glasses. No, freeze it up. I wish water was all I needed. This slide is very important because these are the responses of Muslims and non-Muslims to this question about important Canadian values for immigrants to adopt. And basically, they're saying the same thing. Fluency in language, tolerance, respect for Canadian history, respect for the law, respect for religion, there's really very little difference in the views of Muslim immigrants coming and Canadians that have been here for multiple generations. There's no difference in the views of the two groups. And I think this slide really says a lot. It does not mean that Muslims feel that they should give up their religious identity or observances. Here's an example. A strong majority of Muslims believe that children, and Muslim children in public schools, should have right to pray in those schools. And a smaller majority of non-Muslims support that as well. So that's I think that's important. In terms of the right to wear the niqab in public services, there's the issue of citizenship ceremonies, which, as you may remember, was a political football in the last federal election. Strong majority of Muslims feel that Muslim women should be able to wear the niqab during the ceremony. Other Canadians are more divided, particularly in Quebec. When asked more generally about receiving public services, majorities of both Muslims and non-Muslims believe that women should be able to wear the niqab and receive public services. Okay. Let me turn to another topic, which I think is quite clear that one that's important to address, and that's how Muslims are treated in broader society today. Start off with some positive results. It's interesting, when we asked Muslims what they believe the mainstream opinion was of Islam, in 2006, and even more so in 2016, Muslims felt that the opinion was more likely to be positive than negative. So there's a sense that most Canadians have a positive impression of Islam, although some clearly, that doesn't mean everyone, but that's the general prevailing view. And you can see that that opinion, that perception has strengthened in the last 10 years. How do non-Muslims actually view Islam? The results are not that different. A majority of non-Muslims, or at least a plurality, have a favorable opinion of Islam, although we're not seeing progress over the last 10 years. So we have not seen the movement necessarily. But I think when we put this issue in comparative terms, this slide I think is very clear. Most Muslims, well over 8 in 10, believe that Muslims in Canada are treated better than Muslims in most other Western countries. And we can see that this opinion has strengthened in the last 10 years. So whatever challenges there may be here, things are likely to be worse in Europe, North, and the United States, and so forth. There are concerns that people have, worries about different issues, about how the media portrays Muslims, discrimination against Muslims, issues about violent extremism and what it does in your community. And it's interesting, unemployment among Muslims. Here we can see the trend of concern is much less than it was 10 years ago. But these are all issues of some concern. Of somewhat less concern is the influence of music, the internet on youth, the decline in the importance of religion among Canadian Muslims, and relatively few are worried about stereotyping by neighbors and coworkers. So media stereotyping, yes, but stereotyping by people that they know, much less so, which I think is a hopeful sign. When we asked a question about the most important issue facing one's local Muslim community, open-ended question, the results were quite clear. That it's discrimination, unfair treatment, Islamophobia, even attacks on women wearing hijabs and so forth, that emerged as the issue that Muslims are most likely to identify as a local issue, compared to interaction among different sects, or extremism, or other sorts of things. What's more, 3 in 10 in this group did not identify any particular concerns. So some felt that everything was quite fine. We asked specifically about experiences with discrimination in the last 5 years. For one reason or another, 35% of Muslims say in the last 5 years they had experienced unfair treatment or discrimination because of their religion, because of their ethnicity, because of their language or their sex. You can see how that breaks out. Those numbers to the right add up to more than 35% because people can mention more than one. And those most likely to report these experiences, those born in Canada, women, those under 45 years of age, those living in Quebec, and those born in African countries. How does this compare with the general Canadian experience? When we can compare the results with another survey, with the general social survey done a few years ago, we can see that levels of discrimination are much lower, and Muslims basically are 50% more likely to experience discrimination than the population at large. Where do they experience discrimination? In the workplace, jobs, universities, retail establishments, public transit, and so forth. These are the situations in which people said that they would experience unfair treatment of one sort or another. What about crossing borders, airports primarily? About a quarter of Muslims say that they have experienced being hassled or checked or unfairly considered in airport situations, not necessarily Canadian airports, but Canadian airports as well. And you can see from the slide that this doesn't really matter whether you're a man or a woman, how old you are, or country of birth. It's quite interesting that those born in Canada are more likely to experience difficult times at the border than those who are immigrants. This may have to do with expectations. Canadian-born Muslims may have expectations to be treated like everybody else, more so than perhaps immigrants. And what about feeling inhibited at one point or another about expressing one's opinion due to one's race or ethnicity or religion? 17% said they have felt this way being in Canada. A little more likely it's women, younger Canadians, and those born in this country. So we can see a pattern here in terms of who is feeling the most affected. And then finally, what about the future? What about the treatment of the next generation of Muslims? Will they face more discrimination, less discrimination? The results are somewhat mixed, but a little more likely to feel that the next generation will experience more discrimination and less, and others being somewhat uncertain. And when you look at this by age cohort, it's the youngest group of Muslims, 18 to 34, who in fact are most concerned or less optimistic about what's going to happen in the future. So, looks like I will finish a bit early. I just want to wrap up with a few final points. There's a lot in this research. I can't do justice to all of it here. There is a report, and there's more information available. But let me just leave you with 4 points which I think are perhaps the most important. I think what strikes me when I look at this study and what we can pull out of it is that Muslims as a group are notably positive about being in Canada, about what Canada stands for, and about the acceptance of their religion, despite the reality and the experience of discrimination and stereotyping and Islamophobia that is clearly happening and continues to happen in this country. I think that's a really a notable finding. I think it's a testament to your community. And to me, this is perhaps the most important thing I've taken from this. And I think related to that is Muslims, for the most part in this country, are as connected to the positive values associated with Canada and what it stands for, and multiculturalism, as any group that we can see in this country. They are, in a sense, more Canadian than many other groups of Canadians, including those that whose families have been here for hundreds of years. And I think it's notable that the extent to which religious identity among Muslims is enduring and actually growing stronger over time. And I think this is a notable finding because in the broader Canadian society, the trend is in the other direction. The general trend among most parts of Canadian society is towards becoming less religious and more secular, particularly among youth. So there's a real difference here, which is important. And finally, and I've only touched on this briefly, Muslim youth are, like any generation, developing their own identity about who they are. But I think in this case, it's clear that Muslim youth are less satisfied with the status quo, particularly in terms of treatment of the community in this country, than older generations. And I suspect that we're just starting to see the sort of the impact of this, and those voices will start getting louder as we move on. And with that, thank you very much.